covering the week's top tech stories with a slight Linux bias.
Owners of a device designed to release food for pets say their animals were left hungry during a week-long system failure. In this instance, the device was one from Petnet. However, such devices are being trusted by pet owners. Petnet allows owners to schedule and control feeding via smartphone app. One pet owner tweeted, "My cat starved for over a week," while others complained about other hardware issues. Quote, "My three Gen 2 feeders constantly jam and won't dispense food," wrote another. Some expressed relief that the feeders were now back online. Petnet has two Twitter accounts. The official one has not tweeted since August 2019, but the support account issued four tweets between last week and now about the problems experienced. In its first tweet, it said a system outage was affecting second-generation devices and asked customers not to switch off their feeder even if it appeared to be offline. It said automatic feeds would, quote, still dispense. 4 days later, it tweeted again to say that it hoped to release more information soon. On Friday, it said its smart feeders were, quote, returning online, and a system reset was in progress. Stuart Miles, founder of the tech site Pocketlint, says, quote, "As we go towards a more automated home, you have to acknowledge that somewhere along the line, things will fall over. Robots and automated systems have hiccups along the way. It's something we need to get used to," end quote. This particular outage, though, points to a need for pet owners to have a backup plan. A friend or family member to check in on the pets every couple of days may be all it takes to ensure that if tech fails, a human is there to ensure things are safe and cared for.
Yeah, it makes sense. It really reminds me of the Tesla automated autonomous vehicles.
Yes.
And how there have been some crashes, and it's while they're watching a movie or talking on the phone or like.
This is why I don't think robots are going to take over the world and all the humans
are
going to.
Well, they totally are.
No, well, they need us. Robots need people as much as people need robots.
We got to keep them in check.
You can have an automated cat feeder. Like, I think of people I know in my daily life that really could use an automated cat feeder to help assist them in feeding their cat. But they're not going to hightail it out for 2 weeks and assume that the cat's going to be fine with their automated kitty litter cleaner and their automated cat feeder. Like, they're going to stay there. You can't just trust your cat's life to technology kind of ever.
Yeah. I trust technology.
Yes.
But when it comes to life and death, health, wellness, I think it's important for us to still be the human, right?
Yeah.
Like, autonomous vehicles still have a steering wheel for a reason.
Yes.
You're meant to observe what's going on around you.
Yes.
But sit there and relax. Enjoy the music and just kind of look around and enjoy nature for once. Be a passenger. But as soon as you start swerving toward the guardrail,
be like,
grab a hold of the damn steering wheel and take control.
Right. I honestly don't think that the pet feeder company is at fault in this. Systems go
offline. Well, they are. They totally are. But our complacency in trusting a digitally connected device to provide life-giving food to our pets is a problem.
Right. They didn't say, hey, leave your cat alone for a week.
No. Well, maybe they did. I didn't see the marketing material, but
I hope you didn't.
Understand, this is a connected device that if Wi-Fi goes down, if internet goes down, if their servers go down, which is what happened here, your pets will not get fed.
Right.
Think about that for a second. So we need to still make sure, like, I set an automatic plant feeder when I go away for my annual vacation, okay? Mm-hmm. And it feeds my cucumbers, and it keeps my garden fed.
Yeah.
But my sister-in-law still checks in for us.
Right.
Every couple of days, she goes in and waters the plants and make sure everything's working.
Right.
Because I don't want to come back to a bunch of dead cucumbers.
Just in case something happens.
Don't just
Right.
Willy-nilly trust the tech. We can as a convenience.
Yeah.
But please don't trust it to give life.
I would never trust a robot to keep me alive without human intervention. Like,
you say that now, but wait till you're 95.
No, there will be people there,
There will be nurses.
There will be people
yes,
there checking
exactly.
to make sure the robots yeah. are doing the right thing.
Or Pepper. It could be Pepper.
Oh, Pepper.
She's so cute.
Pepper can be my nurse.
Thank you.